Hello viewers, welcome to the Tech Mecca YouTube channel. Please subscribe our channel, like and share the videos. Today's we gonna discuss about turbine interview questions and answers, which is very important for mechanical students. Let's start the topics. Question number 1, what are 5 types of condensers? Answer: 1. Surface, shell and tube. 2. Jet condenser. 3. Barometric condenser. 4. Air-cooled condenser. 5. Evaporative condenser. Question number 2, why is there a relief valve on a turbine casing? Answer: the turbine casing is fitted with spring-loaded relief valves to prevent damage by excessive steam pressure at the low pressure and if the exhaust valve is closed accidentally. Some casings on smaller turbines are fitted with a sentinel valve, which serves only to warn the operator of overpressure of the exhaust end. A spring-loaded relic valve is needed to relieve high pressure. Question number 3, why must steam turbines be warmed up gradually? Answer: although it is probable that a turbine can, if its shaft is straight, be started from a cold condition without warming up, such operation does not contribute to continued successful operation of the unit. The temperature strain set up in the casings and rotors by such rapid heating have a harmful effect. The turbine, in larger units especially, should be warmed slowly by recommended warm-up ramp rates because of close clearances. Question number 4, what should you lost vacuum while operating a condensing turbine plant? Answer: if vacuum is lost, shut down immediately. The condenser cannot stand steam pressure. The condenser tubes may leak from excessive temperature. Excessive pressure will also damage the shell, the exhaust and the low pressure parts of the turbine. Question number 5, what are the main causes of turbine vibration? Answers: 1. Unbalanced parts. 2. Poor alignment of parts. 3. Loose parts. 4. Rubbing parts. 5. Lubrication troubles. 6. Steam troubles. 7. Foundation troubles. 8. Cracked or excessively worn parts. Question number 6, what is the purpose of a turning gear? Answer: heat must be prevented from warping the rotors of large turbines or high-temperature turbines of 400 degrees centigrade or more. When the turbine is being shut down, a motor-driven turning gear is engaged to the turbine to rotate the spindle and allow uniform cooling. Question number 7, what does heat term ramp rate mean? Answer: ramp rate is used in bringing a turbine up to operating temperature, and as the degree Celsius rise per hour that metal surfaces are exposed to when bringing a machine to rated conditions. Manufacturers specify ramp rates for their machines in order to avoid thermal stresses. Thermocouples are used in measuring metal temperatures. Question number 8, what are some common troubles in surface condenser operation? Answer: the greatest headache to the operator is loss of vacuum caused by air leaking into the surface condenser through the joints or packing glands. Another trouble spot is cooling water leaking into the steam space through the ends of the tubes or through tiny holes in the tubes. The tubes may also become plugged with mud, shells, debris, slime or algae, thus cutting down on the cooling water supply. Corrosion may be uniform, or it may occur in small holes or pits. Question number 9, how would you stop air from leaking into a condenser? Answer: first find the leak by passing a flame over the suspected part while the condenser is under vacuum. The leaks in the flange joints or porous castings can be stopped with asphalt paint or shellac. Question number 10, do you stop cooling water flow through a steam condenser as soon as the turbine is stopped? Answer: you should keep the cooling water circulating for about 15 minutes, also see the manufacturer's recommendation, or more, so that the condenser has a chance to cool down gradually and evenly. Be sure to have cooling water flowing through the condenser before starting up in order to prevent steam from entering the condenser, unless it is cooled. Overheating causes severe leaks and other headaches. Question number 11, why must condensate be subjected to salinity tests where brackish cooling water used? Answer: condensate may leak from the cooling water side to the steam side of condenser and contaminate the feed water, thus causing scale to form in the boilers. Brackish cooling water may leak into the steam space from cracked or porous tubes or ruin around the joints at the end of the tube ends, etc. By taking salinity readings of the condensate, leaks may be found before they can do any harm. Question number 12. How is oil pressure maintained when starting or stopping a medium-sized turbine? Answer. An auxiliary pump is provided to maintain oil pressure. Some auxiliary pumps are turned by a hand crank. Others are motor-driven. This pump is used when the integral pump is running too slowly to provide pressure, as when starting or securing a medium-sized turbine. Question number 13. Why is it poor practice to allow turbine oil to become too cool? Answer. If a turbine oil is allowed to become too cold, condensation of atmospheric moisture takes place in the oil and starts rust on the polished surfaces of the journal bearings. Condensed moisture may interfere with lubrication.